rock and roll, rhythm and moves, and more, much more. So, hi, Anne. Glad to have you on. Dave, glad to have you back. Jay is on. I hear that you got your t-shirt, so woo! And Chris, I think, is going to be doing it at a different time. June, you're back from Cedar Park. I was just up there. And Richard, as usual, give us a shout out if there's something you want to say. I would love for you to just say hello. And we'll wait just a couple more minutes for everyone. We're lucky here. It's another beautiful day. And as you can see, I'm in the Power for Parkinson's studio office today. So hopefully this picture will be a little bit clearer for you, as well as my voice. We have a few more technical accoutrements. So, oh, Natalie is on. Great. Thanks for coming back on, Natalie. So give us a hello and let me know if there's anything I need to know, if somebody's not feeling great or anything like that. Give us a heads up about that. So we are going to be warming up quickly again today, and then we will be doing our chair dance. We're going to try to go all the way through to the end today. I'm going to teach you the end of it. It should be pretty easy for you. Nothing new in the way of movement. And then after that, we'll be moving around a little bit, standing, reviewing our Irish dance again that we learned last week to get ourselves a little more warmed up standing. But you always have the option to do it seated. And then we'll go into our Shine on Your Shoes dance. And remember that the props today are your cane. So you can have this kind of cane, which many of you probably don't have, or this kind of cane, which some of you may have, or a straight cane, or an umbrella with a handle. Remember, we want this about hip height because this will make it easier for you. It can be a little higher than that, depending on what you want. Lighter is better. I know the heavier canes sometimes make it a little bit more difficult to lift up. Yuki is on. Great. Wonderful. So don't forget to have your cane handy or your umbrella for the last part of class. Give us a shout out and let us know that you're there. I know there are a number of you that haven't said hello yet, so hoping everybody is feeling good and ready to move. All right, I'm going to give it maybe one more minute, and then we're going to go ahead and start. So find your comfortable chair. Make sure that you have water nearby if you need to take a sip of water.
And
Oh, good.
And Grace said she can't dance because her foot is sore.
Okay. So Linda Watts is on, and who else besides Linda?
Grace.
Grace, if you would like to do your upper body and anything that you can do avoiding using your foot, or maybe using your good foot and leg and not your bad one, and staying in the chair today, that's fine. So you can do something that will not aggravate that foot. That is always an option for anybody that's having an injury or some kind of problem. But let's go ahead and get started. So sit a little bit forward in your chair. Make sure that your toes are straight ahead. Knees are lined up with your toes and also with your hip sockets. Your shoulders are over your hips, and your chin is resting on that imaginary shelf, allowing your neck muscles to stay soft so that your chin doesn't drop, lift, or push forward. Place your hands on your thighs. And feel the chair coming up underneath you and supporting you and lifting your spine. Let's press against our thighs just a little bit to lift our spine, maybe a quarter of an inch more. That might create some tension. See if you can breathe and keep your spine as long as it is here. And now relax your hands and wrists. Relax your forearms and elbows. Relax your upper arms and shoulders. Soften your neck muscles again. Wiggle your jaw a little bit. Bring your lips together and poof your cheeks out. Good, chipmunks. Suck your cheeks in. Relax your mouth and cheeks. Wrinkle up your nose a couple of times. Relax that. Lift your eyebrows up and down. Up and down. Up and down. Good. Squeeze your face together as though you had crumpled up your whole face like a piece of paper. Now open it out wide. Open your eyes and your mouth as wide as possible. And relax it. Shake it out. Good. Let's begin our counted breathing today. We're going to breathe in for four counts through our nose, out for four counts through our mouth. So a nice, slow four-count inhale, a four-count exhale through the mouth, nice and even, ready to begin, sitting tall. Breathing in, one, two, three, four, out through your mouth, one, two, three, four, and again, one, two, three, four, out through your mouth, one, two, three, four. Relax and breathe normally. Wiggle your toes a little bit inside of your shoes. Relax your toes and feet. Wiggle your fingers and thumbs and relax your fingers and hands. Bring your shoulders up towards your ears and drop them, still lifting your spine. Let's increase the counts now. So we'll breathe in for five counts and out for five counts. Again, another even breath. This time we'll breathe in and out only through our nose, and we'll do this twice. Ready to begin, sitting tall. Breathing in, one, two, three, four, five. Out through your nose, one, two, three, four, five. In through your nose, one, two, three, four, five. Out through your nose, one, two, three, four, five. Relax and breathe normally. Wiggle your shoulders back and forth a little bit of a shimmy. Now we're going to work on that image of an umbrella inside of your chest. So we're working on chest breathing today. We've done a lot of work on abdominal breathing. So I want you to imagine that you have a small umbrella, not like the one that we use for the Shine on Your Shoes dance. But the top of the umbrella is here, and the handle is down at the base of your pelvis. It's very small, and it's closed around the umbrella pole right now. I want you in your mind to picture the umbrella really precisely. See its shape. See the fabric of the umbrella, the texture of that fabric, and the color. Maybe it has a pattern. See the handle. Be very specific. As we breathe in, the umbrella is going to open about a third of the way, expanding your rib cage to the front, sides, and back. As we exhale, the umbrella will close softly around the umbrella pole. We're going to try this breath, nice, easy breath, not too fast, three times. Picture your umbrella inside your torso. Close your eyes if that helps the picturing. Ready to begin? Breathing in, expanding the umbrella three-dimensionally, front, sides, and back, and a soft exhale. Relax the umbrella folds around the umbrella pole. And again, breathing in, expand the umbrella, feel the chest expand, front, sides, and back. Exhale, relax the umbrella around the umbrella pole. One more time, breathe in, feel that umbrella expanding, especially to the back, and an easy exhale. Watch those soft folds of fabric fold down around the umbrella pole. Good. So keep that image also in your parking lot, along with the belly balloon, because in the future we're going to try to do both, and we'll try both happening almost at the same time. Now, wiggle your toes a little bit inside of your shoes, lift your toes up and spread them wide. Keep them up there, press those balls of the feet into the floor. Wiggle your fingers and thumbs, and then lift your fingers and thumbs up and spread your hands. Still sitting tall, drop your toes and relax your feet. Drop your fingers and relax your hands. Bring your shoulders up, push back and down. Up, push back and down. Relax your arms down, turn your arms into wings. And big breath in, the arms float up. Hands come together, exhale, relax the wings. They fold down, shoulders and elbows relax, thumbs at your breastbone. Breathe in here, breathe out, press the fingers up, lengthen your arms as easy as possible. Open your arms, easy shoulders. Breathe in here, breathe out, reach forward towards your screen and down. Try to touch toes or ankles or maybe shins or knees. Breathe in forward, reaching toward the screen and then all the way up to the ceiling. Breathe out, relax the arms down. Let's try that one more time, a little faster. And arms float up, wings float up, nice and soft. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in here, breathe out, lengthen the spine, lengthen the arms. Breathe in, breathe out, reach far forward and down. See if you can go further, round your head over if that's possible. Breathe in, reach toward the screen, all the way up to the ceiling. Breathe out, hands come together, relax the shoulders and elbows, sit very tall. Right away today, hands are pushing forward, cross your thumbs. Push the arms forward, spread the space in between your shoulder blades. Scoop your pelvis under, belly in, soften the chest. Drop your chin and breathe out. Breathe in, lift your pelvis up on your sit bones, lift your spine, open your hands, reach behind you, squeeze your shoulder blades together. Breathe out, breathe in again, breathe out. Let's go into the rounding contraction. Your spine is the letter C from tailbone to the top of your head. Breathe in. Lift the spine, letter I, squeeze your shoulder blades together as you reach behind you and open your chest. Breathe out, contract and round the spine from tailbone to head. Breathe in, lift the spine, expand the chest, squeeze the shoulder blades together. One more, contract, letter C, breathe out. Expand, lift, letter I. Relax the arms down. Roll the shoulders again. Up, push back and down. Up, push back and down. Good. Let me see if I can get that to repeat. Nope. There we go. Keep your arms down. Rotate from the shoulder socket so the palms and inside elbows face the front and then they face the back. They face the front and the back. They face the front and the back. They face the front. Lift the arms up, out to the sides, hands lower than your shoulders. Palms are facing the ceiling, inside elbows looking at the ceiling. From here, shift and reach for the walls. Shift those ribs and reach for the walls. Make that shift bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. Come back to center. Float the arms up again. Cross the thumbs. Make your pencil point. Now draw your pencil point across the ceiling, making lines, lengthening your side ribs, lifting your spine, getting taller. Coming back to center. Put a dot on the ceiling. Open the hands. Bend the elbows. Press forward to straight arms. Bend the wrists, fingers down and up, down and up, down and up. Pull back. Push the walls away from you. Straight arms, bend the wrists, fingers down and up, down and up, down and up. Pull in. Good. Push forward again. Spread the fingers really wide, glue them together. Really wide, glue them together. Cross your thumb, wrap your fingers around your thumb, bend your elbows, stir the chili in the pot, moving those wrists. Big stirs and reverse, bigger, big wrist movements. That's it. Wiggle those fingers, play the semicircular piano as you're wiggling your fingers. Good. Come back to center. Right arm stays forward. Left arm goes back and swing. Relax the arms now. Now they're loose and stretchy. Those muscles are relaxed, but you're sending that energy flowing down your arms, through your elbows, wrists, into your hands, out your fingertips like laser beams, turning you into those superheroes that we know you are. Turn your head now towards your back hand. And come to center. Shoulders up and drop, up and drop, up and drop. All right, wiggle a little forward. I'm going to speed the music up just a little bit. So let me start here. Everybody move forward toward your chair. Hold your chair seat. One foot out and in. Other side, out and in. A little faster. Out and in. Out and in. Touch your heel. Out and in. out to the diagonal side, out and in, out and in, out and in, out, back to center and out and in, out, off the floor, out and in, out. Let's add the arms, out and in, out and in, two more, out and in, out, and hold your chair, diagonal side and in, out and in, off the floor, off the floor. Add the arms, push, really push with the bottom of your foot, two more, push. Good, very nice. Toe heel out, ankles underneath your knees, nice right angle here. Lift your spine, hands inside your thighs, breathe in. Exhale, press the thighs open, release. Press open, release. Press open, release. Press open and stay, tilt forward. Good. Keep pressing those thighs out. Push down in your feet. Press your chest toward the floor. And sit tall. Relax the arms. Opposite shoulders coming up and down. Good. Reach across. Big circle. Up, out, and down. Other side. Reach across. Big circle. Up, out, and down. So across. This is a porte-bras. Up, out, and down. Across, porte-bras, up, out, and down. Both arms float out and up to fifth, open to second, and down to bras-bas. Open to second, up to fifth, open back out to second, and bras-bas. Open out to second, stay there, toe heel in. Good, hold your chair, slide your right leg out, keep it there. Pull those toes back toward the shin. Place your hand on your opposite thigh. Breathe in. Exhale. Tilt from your hip sockets here. Pull those toes up to look up your nose. All right. I don't know if your nose likes that. Reach for your foot. Now slice the air. Arms all the way up, out, and down. Bring that leg in. Tap, tap, tap. Other side. Push that heel forward. Toes pulling back towards your shin. Hands on the opposite thigh, breathe in. Exhale, tilt from the hip sockets. Toes looking up your nose. Good, reach for that foot. Slice the air, up, out, and down. Bring it in, tap, tap, tap. All right, we're gonna work a little bit on steps. Step, touch, step, touch, step, touch, step, touch, step, touch. Step, touch, step, touch, step, touch. So if you're doing your dances in the chair, that's what it'll look like when you step, touch. Let's try heel, cross, together. Heel, cross, together. Shuffle, step, shuffle, step, shuffle, step, shuffle, step. Heel, cross, together. Heel, cross, together. Four shuffles. Shuffle. Remember, you can just swing your leg forward and back if you can't get the shuffle. One more time. Heel, touch, together. Heel, touch, together. Shuffle, step, shuffle, step, shuffle, step, shuffle, step. Step and touch with the toe to the back. So step, touch, step, touch, step, touch. Toe goes under your chair here. Step, touch, step, touch, step, touch, step, touch. Good. Legs are open. Wiggle a little forward. Going to work on those hips. So little rotation. Back heel up. Rotate from the hip socket and open. Little rotation again. And back to center. Only go to the place where it's comfortable. Never go to a place of pain when you're doing this. This is a soft rotation. Good. Twist and twist. Good. Toe heel back in. Let's just do an easy spine twist. So take your hands and wrap them. Grab the lower part of the chair and grab the outside of your right thigh. Look behind you. Breathe. Swing the arms forward, around. Grab the outside of that chair in the back. Grab the outside of your left thigh. Turn and look behind you. Breathe. And come back. Open the arms, fingertips to your shoulders. Gentle twist. Back and forth, getting taller each time. Let your head go with it. And relax the arms out. Float down. Let's have some laughing shoulders. Ha, 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 ha. Good job. All right, let's march. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Lift the legs nice and high. 5, 6, 7, 8. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now open out. 4, 3, 2, 1. In 4, 3, 2, 1. Out 4, 3, 2, 1. In 4, 3. Ready for some jumps. Open, close, 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 open, close. Four more. 4, 3, 2, 1. Woo! And relax. Wiggle forward. Bring your shoulders, elbows, and arms forward. Up, open, out. And forward, contraction, expansion. Forward, lift, and open. Initiate with your shoulders, then elbows, then round over. Up to fifth and open. One more. Round. Up and open. Good. Okay. Take a breath. Grab some water if you need to. We're going to go into our Chariots of Fire dance. Remember, Chariots of Fire is from the movie Chariots of Fire. The song, the music is actually by Vangelis or Vangelis, and this is played by the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra. We're going to go right away today to that place in the dance where you have just finished the 16 counts that are your counts. So the 16 counts happen, and remember I asked you to finish facing directly front. Directly front, facing your screen, also called downstage, okay? From here, we're going to go back to that brushing action. So we're going to brush starting with the left. Left, right, left, right. Everybody got that? Now we're gonna fan kick, so you have to move your hands quickly after the right, fan kick, to the left corner, to the left corner. So we're here, you've just finished the right, grab the chair, left, right, to the corner. So it's less than a quarter of a turn. And remember, if you can't get the fan kick, you can lift your legs, or you can just step it over to that diagonal. From here, we're going to expand 1, 2, 3, 4, contraction. And drop the arms over. So I showed you this last week. Then we have the up overs. Up over 1, 2, 3, 4. That's toward the back. 5, 6, 7, 8. Back to the front. 1, 2, 3, 4. Toward the back. 5, 6, 7, 8. That's the front. That's where we have left it. That's where we have left it. We're going to add 4 more brushes from here, but this time we're going to start with the right foot. That's the one the right leg, the right foot is the one closest to your screen. So it's this one, closest to your screen. So we're going to brush right, left, right, left. Then we're going to do our run with this leg back. 2, 3, 4. So again, after you finish the up overs, we brush 1, 2, 3, 4, just like we did on the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we're going to expand. 1, 2, 3, 4. Contract, bring that leg in just a little bit. 6, 7, 8, there's our contraction like we did in the beginning of class. Expand 2, 3, 4. Just like in the beginning of the dance, you're going to take this leg, front leg, fan kick back to the front. From here, 3 of these, just like what we did earlier. 2, 3. Hold the chair, torso circle, right forward, left center. We're going to do one more of these. And then if we have time for the music, we'll do another one. And finish. And you'll finish here, facing front, arms down. Very simple. So let's go over that again. Let's go over that again. You've just finished your 16 counts, which I hope you're thinking about, okay? We start with the left, because remember we came from over here. So left, brush, 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 hold, fan kick to the left side. Yes, from here, expand, contract, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We're going to reverse the whole thing. Right, left, right, left. Hold the back of the chair. Brush. This is our pawing, exaggerated run. 4. Expand, 1, 2, 3, 4, contract, 6, 7, 8, expand, 2, 3, 4, hold your chair, fan kick to center, contract over, up to fifth, think about your focus, down and up, third time, down and up, hold the chair, torso circle, and over and up and over and up and finish. Okay, everybody got that? So let's see if we can run the whole thing from the beginning. I can't guarantee that I will remember this any better than you will, okay? I'm going to move that out of the way. Let's move over toward the right corner of the chair. We're facing the right. Got to find my music. Here we go. Let me just test it. All right, so let's try going through the 16 counts. Then we'll stop the music, and then we'll continue, okay? I'll stop it right after your 16 counts, and I'm going to count you through your 16 counts. After that, we'll continue with what we just did with the music. We'll see if we can get at least that far today. Rounded slightly over, hands on the thighs, feet are even with each other. That was the first trumpet. That was the second trumpet. Third one. Fourth one. Fifth one, arm circle. Left, laser beams coming out of your fingers and toes. Exaggerated run. Repeat. Expand. Contract. Expand. Fan kick, hold your chair. And contract over up to fifth. Three times. Torso circle. Here comes your 16 counts. And one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Okay, any questions on that? If you have questions on this or questions about the 16 counts, put them in the chat right now so I know, because I want to be able to answer your questions. Anybody have any questions? So we're good up to here. Yes, I can't see you. I'm hoping you're sending me two thumbs up. Yes. Okay. So from here, remember your 16 counts. Wherever you moved with your running, leaping, or jumping, you must end facing the front, because now we're going to start with the brushes again. So here we go. Brush, brush, brush. Fan kick, fast expansion. Out and in and up, over, up, over, up, over, starting with the right leg. Rush, 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 rush. Hold the back of the chair, exaggerated run. Now expand, contract, expand, fan kick to front, and over, up. Second one, third one, torso. Last two. Good. Okay. So even though we chopped it in half to give you a little bit of breathing time for your brain, yes, we did it. We did it. So I know this is a complex dance. So we'll do it again next week. We'll do it again next week. And this next week, we'll do it together, no stopping. So keep reviewing your 16 counts.
One question from
you. Yes, one question.
Jane wanted to know if the movement is on the second note of the trumpet?
The movement on the is on the second note of the trumpet. Jane, yes. So technically, it's ba-da, so this is da da. Second one is da da. Yes, that's your head. Third one is da da. So your arm goes move, move. Fourth one, da da. Fifth one, and up. So there's that and move. Yes? So we're using the and as a preparation, and the completion of the movement happens on the second note of the trumpet. Good question. Very good question. Okay. For those of you who are musically trained, quite a few of you, yes. All right. So wiggle forward in your chairs, and let's have some happy music. Bring those ankles underneath your knees, hands on the chair or on your thighs, ready to rock four times. And lift, come down. Push down into the chair with the hands and push down into the floor. Let's come all the way up now. Push, lift, push down in your legs, lift up in your torso. Breathe, clear focus. Sit down if you're dizzy. Clapping. Clear beat. Add your feet. Walk around to the back of your chair. So you're going to hold your chair if you need to. And you're marching. Whoops. I'm over to the side so you can see my legs. We're marching. Open out, back in, back out, back in. Good. All right. Feet are parallel, shoulders over the hips. Lift your belly, lift your chest. Little plie and straight, releve and down. We're in parallel position and lift and lower. Plie and straight, releve, and down. One more, plie, and straight, releve, and down. Rotate from your hip sockets to first position. Heels are touching, feet are in a V. You gotta lift your belly and your chest and spine. Plie, straight, releve, and down. Still holding your chair, and straight, push your head up and down. Open to second, four plies with a releve. And plie and straight, releve and down. Plie and straight, releve and down. Plie and straight, releve and down. Good. Wiggle your feet in. Back to parallel. Step, touch. Good. Step touch back. Toe to the back. Now just shift, shift, shift. Glide your hands along the back of the chair just like you're holding the cane. That's it. Good. Come back to center. Step your feet in. Let's practice our Irish step. Touch the toe, heel. One, two, three. Touch the toe, heel. One, two, three. 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 Good. All right. We're going to practice a pie wedge turn. So open your right foot slightly to the side. You can do this behind your chair. Now take your left foot, open, close, open, close, open, close. And there you are, facing the front again. Practice one more time. Open, close, open, close, open, close, open, close. A good way to think about this when you're turning around yourself, number one, don't keep your legs too close together. Have some space. Second thing is think, I'm going to face this wall. I'm going to face this wall. I'm going to face this wall. And I'm going to face this wall. Yes? All right. So behind your chair, step out and plie, shift, plie, shift, plie, shift, plie, shift, plie, shift and reach, 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 reach. Lift the leg, opposite leg from arm. Two more. Good. Step out, step out. Second position, plie. A little bit bigger. A little bit bigger. Pull those skinny jeans on. Zip that magic zipper. Flatten your toothpaste tube from your tailbone all the way up. Come on, flatten front body to back body. Squirt it out the top of your head onto the ceiling and grow an inch. Let go. Let go with both hands if possible, or just one. Wipe that toothpaste off the ceiling. Open wide. Show me your jazz hands. And tilt. And tilt. Bend your knees. Tilt a little bit more with your hips. Get those hips moving. All right, hold your chair, bend your knees, toe heel in, wiggle your hips. Okay, I'm going to move my chair out of the way, but if you need to have your chair, go ahead and have your chair. Come back and sit down if you need it. Let me move my papers out of the way. So we're going to go back to the Irish dance that we did last week for St. Patrick's Day. And we're going to review again. Hands start on hips. Make sure that you have enough room to move this way, side to side, as well as forward and back, even though you're not going to be moving too far. Hands are on your hips. We start with a bounce. One and two and three and four, five and six, and this is the drums. Four sets of eight. The fourth one, you're going to hear that fiddle start, a low droning sound. Then we start with the right touch and heel and march, march, march. Now the left foot, touch and heel and march, march, march. It's uneven, therefore we flip back and forth between right and left. We alternate. Touch the right and heel, march right, left, right. Touch the left and heel, march left, right, left. Four times. We walk forward, very small steps. Right, left, right, touch. Back, left, right, left, touch. Forward, right, left, right, touch. Back, left, right, left, touch. Then we start over again. Now remember, if it's troublesome for you to back up, make the steps very small or just do them in place. Just do them in place. From here, after we've backed up the forward, back, forward, back, that second back up. We start this again, toe, heel, one, two, three, right, left, right, left. Ready on the right foot to walk forward, eight counts. Arms float up, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. We just stepped on our left, therefore we are ready with our right foot. And here comes that turnaround. Right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. Hands come down. So there's that pie or clock turn. Again, arms are up. Right, left, we're facing that wall. Right, left, we're facing the back. Right, left, now we're facing this wall. Right, left, and hands come down to your hips. Three steps to the side, step together. Fourth one is step touch. Step together, step together, step together, step touch. Go back the other way. We repeat that again, to the right, to the left. We stay here, we bounce for four, and we start over. All right, very easy. We're going to do the whole thing from the beginning. Now, this is called O'Sullivan's March, and it's from the Essential Chieftains album by the Chieftains, my favorite Irish group. Hands on the hips, ready. Two, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, three, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, four, two, three, four, five, six. Get ready. Here we go. Let me start again. I'm off just a little bit, just a little bit. Whoops. Keep bouncing. Here we go. Here we go. Touch, heel, right, left, right. Left touch and heel. Left, right, left. And touch and heel. March, march, march. And touch and heel. March, march, walking forward. Right, left, step, touch. Back, back, step, touch. Forward, forward, step, touch. Back, back, step, start over. Double touch and heel. One, two, three. Touch, heel. One, two, three. Repeat, touch, heel. One, two, three, and touch and heel. And here comes our big walk forward. Right foot, one, two, three, four, five, six. Now we're turning. Right, right, left, right, left. Hands on the hips. Step to the right, step to the right, step to the right, step, touch, step to the left, step to the left, step to the left, step, touch. Step to the right, step, touch. Step to the left, step, 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 four bounces. Start over, touch, heel. One, two, three, and touch, and heel. One, two, three, and touch, and heel. One, two, three, and touch, and heel. And one, two, three, walking forward, 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 touch, back, 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 touch, forward, 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 touch, back, back, start, over, touch, heel. That was double touch. And left, and touch, heel. And touch, heel. Walking forward, two, three, four, five, six. Turning to the right, 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 right. And step together, step together, step together, step and touch. Step together, step together. Step together, step and touch. You're getting very warmed up. I hope you're smiling. And everybody take a bow or curtsy. All right, good job. Okay, grab your canes. You should be very warmed up now. I've been working with those marching steps and moving around. So, let's go to Shine on Your Shoes, and let's go through the first section all the way up to where we stopped, which is that the cane is on your right shoulder and you're here when he says wonderful. Okay, all right, little glitch there. So I want you to grab your cane. We're going to do this with music, starting from the beginning. Remember, make sure you have plenty of space. The cane is in your left hand. Right foot is slightly forward. Right hand is up, ready to go. And you're smiling. Three, four, five, six. Flip the cane. Shift, shift. Shift, shift, walk, 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 step touch, shift, 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 walk, 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 step touch. Put the cane down, tie, crease in your pants, swing it around, big smile. Give your shoes a shine, two little bounces over the left shoulder. Step, arm gesture. Go back to the left. Put the cane down right in front, both hands. Heel, toe together. Heel, toe together. Four shuffles. Shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. Picking the cane up onto your hip. The happy-go-lucky, flip that hand. Step touch to the back. Catch step, left. A melody in your heart. What a wonderful way to start the day. It's time that to get in the barber shop. Pivot. Choo-choo. Pivot. Turn. Chalk. Push. Push. Eraser on the back of your head. In front. Big wide stance. Get ready. Right hand. Over that right shoulder. Step right. Turning and stop here. Okay, good. Okay, everybody got it? So right from there, you've walked around for eight counts. Now, we're going to come back to putting the cane down here, and you're going to go step, touch, step, touch, step, touch, step, touch. So instead of this, you're just stepping to the front. Four step touches, yes? So the only thing we're adding right now is an eight count turn, seven, eight, step. The cane and the right foot will go down at the same time. Step, touch, step, touch, step, touch, step, touch. And then I have a surprise for you. So let's do the whole thing one more time. Get that turn in, and then go into the step touches. Okay. Cane is in your left hand. three, four, five, six, seven. Flip the cane. Shift. Walk. Step touch. Shift. Walk. Step touch. Cane goes down. Tie. Pants. Swing it around. Both hands. Smile. Give your shoes a shine. Two bounces. Over the left. Walk. Two, three, four. Step. Touch. Walk. Two, three, four. Put the cane down in front. Both hands. Heel, toe together. Heel, toe together. Four shuffles. Pick it up onto your hip. Flip that hand. Face the front. Step touches. Here comes your catch step. Right, left. In your heart. Wonderful way to start the day. Here it comes. Pivot. Pivot. Chalk. Push, push. Eraser on the back of your head, in front. Turning. Big wide stance. Right hand. Over your right shoulder. Three, four, five, six. Turning. Right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. Step, touch, step, touch. I did it in back. There. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. Okay. Hear that 28 counts? That's your homework. Your homework is to begin to work on 28 counts using the movements that you have already done in the dance. You can add something new if you want, but 28 counts. So three sets of eight plus four. Take all the movements that you know and love that you've just been doing in this dance. You can pick two, you can pick three, you can pick four. You choose, okay? If you want to add something new, that's fine. That's your assignment. We'll have time to work on it next week, yes? So put your canes down. It's time to say adieu. And let me find Mr. Frank. Here we go. So, there we go. Frank Sinatra, as always, young at heart. I hope you've had a great workout today. Fairy tales can come true. It can happen to you if you're young at heart. For it's hard, you will find, to be narrow of mind if you're young at heart. You can go to extremes with impossible schemes. You can laugh when your dreams fall apart at the seams. And life gets more exciting with each passing day. It sure does. And love is either in your heart or on its way. All right, plant your feet. Big smile. Take a little bow for yourselves. And again, a little bit bigger smile and a little bit bigger bow. And this time, biggest smile of your day. All right. Bow to your right. Bow to your left. Bow to anyone you are with who made it possible for you to do this class today. Bow to everybody on the screen. And here is the best part. You have a head start. If you are among the very young at heart, and we are always, okay. All right, thank you. Give yourselves two pats on the back. That was a big workout today. Gold stars. All right, good work, everybody. So give us a shout out again. If you want to make a comment or you have a question, I know, Jane, you're always asking me about the catch step. So the Jackie Gleason catch step, by the way, is you've just done this. So you're going to step on the right, but you're going to kind of hop it. Da-dum. So you're going to go up, down, out. Up, down, out. That's your catch step. So right, then left, then step on the left. That's our Jackie Gleason catch step. Anybody have any specific questions?
Just a few people you didn't get. Oh,
okay. All right. Thank you, Jay. Adieu to you. And Grace and Jane, thank you. And Barbie, I'm glad you're there. Joan, as always, and I hope you were able to do some of that, even though you couldn't do everything. And Grace as well, I hope you did as much as you can. Because even if you can't move something, and believe me, I've had this experience sometimes even teaching a class with my arm in a sling, okay? It's what happens in here that is truly important. So you're still learning, even if you're moving two-thirds of your body and not the whole thing. So Barbie, thanks. Joan, thanks. Carol, good. And, oh, good, Jane. Second class of your day. Woo! Carla is back again. I am so glad. Robert, yes. Three cheers. He got his second vaccine today. So, and Richard and Linda and Dave, thank you, as always, for coming on and supporting this class. So thank you, everybody. I'm so glad that you were here today. So happy that you all showed up. Keep working. Now, remember, your homework assignment is 28 counts, but you get to steal all of my choreography, unless you want to make up something new. You can take anything you want. Okay, and then we'll talk about it next week. You can give me some questions if it's not working and you have questions. But it's going to begin to push your brain to figure out which foot do I start on, which foot do I end, you know, should I be facing this way? That's what I want you to do. I want you to begin to push your brain to do it yourself, okay? Good tool for advancing the brain a little bit more than what we've been doing. So any other questions from anybody? Any comments? Don't forget to thumbs up for our classes on YouTube, also Facebook and Instagram. And as always, if you need to send me an email, you can send it directly to the office. I will get it and I will answer you. Anything else that we're missing? Okay. Have a wonderful day. Have a great weekend. Take care of yourselves. Be well. And you know my rule, no falling. Okay? And I will see you next week. I'll see you on Monday, and then I'll see you on Thursday again, if not before. Okay. Thank you. Lots of love. Bye.